Hi guys, welcome to a new video. So today's video is going to be a cooking video. So my mother got mushrooms from the local market and she was like, cook your chili fry, the usual chili fry. And I was like, I don't want to cook chili fry. You have already seen that video. If you've not seen, you can click the link up here somewhere. I will put the link of the mushroom chili fry which I did like a year ago, and you know, I wanted something different. It's always like mushroom each time we get mushrooms, it's always mushrooms chili fry, and I didn't want that. So I decided to have mushroom in gravy style, no dry chili fry, nothing. Mushroom in gravy, but I added potatoes. I baked potatoes and I added it in this dish. That is how I prepared it. So this video is already recorded. Yesterday the cooking was done. Today I'm just giving you an intro of, you know, what I cooked. So I want to call it mushroom potato in gravy. I cannot give any fancy names, but you can decide for yourself what the dish is, because you cannot call it curry exactly. I don't know. Just watch the video how I prepared the mushroom potato in gravy. So, you know, let's get into the whole preparation cooking. I have 6 potatoes over here. I have washed them thoroughly thrice in water, and now we are going to cut them in like big chunks. This is going to add in that starchy flavor. Here we have my pot ready. Water is already in it. To this I'm going to add salt. We are going to cover the lid of this pot and let it simmer. Let the water come to the boiling temperature, and once it is all in the boiling stage, we are going to add the potatoes. Water is already boiling here. We are going to add the chopped potatoes in this, the chunky potato that I chopped earlier. We are going to add in it. We are going to let it sit, not until the potatoes are completely boiled. We want them semi-boiled. Like I have mentioned in the video, I'm going to bake these potatoes, so I want them like slightly hard on the outside and juicy tender on the inside. So we are going to let it simmer until it's semi-boiled. Obviously this dish cannot be complete without the mushrooms. We are going to chop the mushrooms over here. Whatever we have, big mushrooms over here, we are going to cut them in halves. Otherwise I want to maintain that mushroom like shape. So this is the whole cutting process. I'm not going to speak ahead of the cutting process. Just watch me cut the whole thing. I'm not going to skip this part, man. You have to watch me chop the whole bunch of mushrooms. Okay, you just thought this cutting process would be never ending, but here we have my mushrooms chopped and we are going to set that aside. Now the potatoes are semi done. I have placed them on a baking sheet, drizzled some olive oil and a pinch of salt all over. So it's all set to bake at 180 degrees Celsius for about 20 minutes. Let's get ready with the actual preparation. We are going to prepare sauté. I'm going to peel 3 large onions and chop them in fine pieces, because this is going to add that flavor and thickness to the gravy. So here we have my 3 onions all peeled, and thankfully they were semi-pink and white onions. I didn't have tears to shed during the whole cutting process. Again, you have to watch me cut all these 3 onions. I cannot cut this fast. This is just a video effect of speeding things up. All I'm doing is cutting at a normal speed. I don't want to bore you, and I don't want to get bored watching myself cut the onions and do this voiceover. Gravy is not possible without the tomato puree. Here I am chopping the tomatoes in large chunks so that I can blend them in my mixie. I have added 10 garlic cloves, a piece of ginger, little bit of water to this. I'm going to add those chunky tomato pieces, and it's all set to get pureed. My trusty NutriBullet is all set to blend all these ingredients, and my tomato puree is all ready. To the saute, I'm going to add 7 chilies. I'm going to cut them in halves. I'm going to slice them in between, and we will add this. Obviously, the chilies will add that flavory spiciness to my dish. Did you know cutting chilies in halves like this in between is really hard? It requires some sort of a dedication to get it done so perfectly. Or I'm just trying to distract you to watch the whole cutting process of the chilies till the end. While I was cutting the chilies, I had placed the onions in the pot with some oil to let it sit and, you know, turn light golden brown. That's how you do the saute thing. To this, I'm going to add those chilies that are already cut. Okay, my saute is almost done. We are going to add the chilies here, and to this, once the saute is all ready, we are going to add tomato puree to this. And once tomato puree is added, a little bit of residue of the tomato puree is there on my jar. I had to add some water and, you know, clear that jar from the tomato puree. To add some flavor, we are going to add vegetable broth. Here we have 2 crushed vegetable cubes. We are not using chicken cubes, we are using vegetable cubes. I have added hot water. We are going to let it dilute, and this is what I'm going to add to the whole mushroom dish mix. Mushrooms are already added in the pot here now. We are going to let it simmer for a while. To this simmer, I'm going to add the vegetable broth, and in no time I should be adding the potatoes. To thicken the gravy, I'm adding 2 teaspoons of corn flour. To this, I'm adding some hot water to get the corn flour all diluted and well incorporated in the water. And once that is done, I'm going to add this to my dish. Obviously, we want a thick gravy, and with a thick gravy, you can dip your bread and have, or you can even eat it with your chapati. Here we have my mushroom dish on a boil. We have added the corn flour mix, and we are going to let it sit for a while. I have added turmeric powder and red chili powder too to this. You would think the red chili powder and the 7 chilies would make the dish spicy, but no. The potatoes that I'll be adding and the corn starch that I have added in the dish will mellow down the spiciness. Usually I like my dish savory and spicy. For now, I'm going to cover the pot with the lid and let the mushrooms cook for a while. No dish is complete without salt, so I'll be adding a teaspoon of salt to the dish. And lastly, once you have turned off your stove, you are going to add in the baked potatoes, and you are going to give it a good mix, a good stir. Final stir is what I'm going to give this dish. To my surprise, I had already put a spoon in the dish and it sunk into the dish. Wow, what a surprise. So there was already a spoon and sunk in the pot. Now I'm going to carry on with the mixing. I'm going to put this spoon away for wash, and we are going to fold everything, you know, so that everything is mixed and the potatoes dance in the mushrooms into this whole spicy gravy. Lastly is the final garnishing. You can add fresh coriander leaves or parsley leaves, but I'll be adding dried herb mix to this. Since I have mentioned that I'll be adding a teaspoon of salt, here is that part, but somehow my camera didn't capture me adding the dried herbs. You can, like I said, you can either add coriander leaves, fresh coriander leaves, or parsley leaves. That is all. My dish is prepared, and believe me, the dish was so good that my family really liked this dish. This is what finally it looks like on a plate. Yum. Okay guys, that's all for this video. I hope you liked this video. I hope you liked the whole cooking process. It was quite a tedious process for me. Actually, my sister and my mom were out all day, and I thanked them for being out all day. There was no disturbance in the kitchen. I had the kitchen to myself. I got the room to myself in the kitchen. I could cook however, whatever ingredients I wanted to put. Everything was there in the pantry. Although I missed to show you that I added a little bit of turmeric, red chili powder, and in the end I added all herb spice which you get ready made. They are dried herbs in a jar. I had ordered, actually they were a combo pack of 200 grams each, and I have that stored inside. I have not opened both. I only, for my instant use, I have it stored in a small glass jar. So that is what I added in the dish, and believe me, the mushroom in gravy, mushroom potato in gravy, turned out delicious. Of course, when you're using artificial flavoring like your chicken broth or your vegetable broth, the food turns out delicious. And I don't usually opt for artificial flavoring. I believe in preparing home spices, like home ground spices in your home, preparing curry in your homes. Nothing is store-bought usually in my house, but this is what I did different, and believe me, everybody in my family really liked what I cooked. So I don't really know, it is a matter of preference. I don't know what you are going to call this. You're going to call this mushroom potato in curry or mushroom potato in gravy. I would call it gravy, because curry, usually to my knowledge, curry is prepared out of coconut milk. This is not prepared out of coconut milk. I have just used tomato puree and corn flour in hot water. I have mixed that and I have added to my dish. That's how the curry turned out, nice, creamy and thick. So it is a matter of preference how you want to prepare your curry or gravy. I would call it gravy, actually. I don't know what you think. You can share your thoughts, you know. That's all for my cooking video today. If you like this video, hit the like button. Until then, bye.